Hello guys, this is Indian Medico and in this video we are going to see about membrane over tonsil. This is a concise presentation for medical students. The palatine tonsils are two lymphatic tissue masses. There is one tonsil located on each side of the oropharynx in the back of the throat. Many conditions can present with formation of membrane over tonsil. Now let us see about the differential diagnosis of membrane over tonsil. In order to remember the various conditions causing the formation of membrane over tonsil, remember the phrase MALA is deficient in vitamin DC. M stands for membranous tonsillitis and malignancy of tonsil. A stands for agranulocytosis. L stands for leukemia. Another A stands for aphthous ulcers. V stands for Vincent angina. I stands for infectious mononucleosis. T stands for traumatic ulcer. D stands for diphtheria and C stands for candidal infection of tonsil. So remember the mnemonic MALA is deficient in vitamin DC. Now let us see about each of these conditions in detail. Membranous tonsillitis is usually caused due to pyogenic organisms. An exudative membrane forms over the medial surface of tonsil along with features of acute tonsillitis. This is how a patient with acute membranous tonsillitis presents to you. Diphtheria has slower onset and it causes less local discomfort in comparison with acute membranous tonsillitis. The membrane extends beyond the tonsils onto the soft palate and is dirty grey in color. The membrane is adherent and its removal leaves a bleeding surface. Urine examination reveals albumin. Smear and culture of throat swab reveals Cornibacterium diphtheriae. This is how a patient with diphtheria presents to you. Vincent angina is insidious in onset and it causes less fever and less discomfort in throat in comparison with acute membranous tonsillitis. The membrane can be easily removed, revealing an irregular ulcer on the tonsil. Throat swab reveals the causative organisms, that is fusiform bacilli and spirochetes. This is how a patient with Vincent angina presents to you. In infectious mononucleosis, both tonsils are very much enlarged, congested and covered with membrane. There will be marked local discomfort. There will be enlarged lymph nodes in the posterior triangle of neck along with splenomegaly. Atypical cells can be seen in blood smear. Paul Bunnell test reveals high titer of neutrophil antibody. Infectious mononucleosis doesn't respond to antibiotics. This is how a patient with infectious mononucleosis presents to you. Agranulocytosis can also present with membrane over tonsil. Agranulocytosis leads to ulcerative necrotic lesions in oropharynx. The patient will be severely ill. It can be diagnosed using total leukocyte count and differential leukocyte count. Total leukocyte count reveals decreased number of white blood cells and differential leukocyte count reveals decreased number of neutrophils. This is how a patient with agranulocytosis presents to you. Leukemia can also present with formation of membrane over tonsil. It can be diagnosed using total leukocyte count, presence of anemia and presence of blast cells on bone marrow examination. Aphthous ulcers can also present with formation of membrane over tonsil. Aphthous ulcers are benign and non-contagious ulcers in oral cavity or oropharynx. Aphthous ulcers are very painful. This picture shows an aphthous ulcer in the oral cavity. If this type of ulcer occurs in the tonsil, it can lead to formation of membrane over the tonsil. Malignancy of tonsil can also present with formation of membrane over tonsil. Most malignancies of tonsils are squamous cell carcinomas. The patient complains of sore throat, otalgia, dysphagia, and presence of lump in throat. This is how a patient with malignancy of tonsil presents to you. Traumatic ulcer can also lead to the formation of membrane over tonsil. This is because injury to oropharynx usually heals by formation of membrane. Tonsils can be injured by toothbrush, pencils or fingers. The membrane appears within 24 hours. Candidal infection of tonsil can also lead to the formation of membrane over tonsil. It is caused in immunosuppressed patients and due to excessive use of antibiotics and steroids. This is how a patient with candidal infection of throat presents to you. Now, How do you diagnose a case with membrane over tonsil? Thorough history should be taken, physical examination should be done, total leukocyte count and differential leukocyte count can be done to diagnose agranulocytosis, leukemia, neutropenia and infectious mononucleosis. Blood smear can be done. It can reveal atypical cells in infectious mononucleosis. Throat swab and culture should be done. This can reveal membranous tonsillitis, Vincent angina, diphtheria and candidal infection. Bone marrow aspiration or needle biopsy can be done. Paul Bunnell test or monospot test can be done to diagnose infectious mononucleosis. And biopsy of the lesion can be taken for diagnosis. If you have any suggestions, please let me know in the comment section. If you like this video, please like, share, subscribe and tell your friends about this channel. Thank you.